1 and 6.
Now faith is being sure of what we hope for, and certain of what we do not see. Now faith is being sure of what we hope for, and certain of what we do not see. And without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to Him must believe. And without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to Him must believe that He exists and that He rewards those who earnestly seek Him. That He exists and that He rewards those who earnestly seek Him. Now faith is being sure of what we hope for, and certain of what we do not see. Now faith is being sure of what we hope for, and certain of what we do not see. And without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to Him must believe. And without faith it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to Him must believe that He exists and that He rewards those who earnestly seek Him. That He exists and that He rewards those who earnestly seek Him. Now faith is being sure of what we hope for.
commanded you? Haven't I commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened and do not be dismayed. Be strong and courageous.
Mana mana. Mana mana. Mana mana. Mana mana. Mana mana. Mana mana.
Good morning, DTV Kids. So glad that you could join us this morning, Sunday, December 13th, online. We are so excited to be bringing you this message this morning. Again, as we are in Christmas season, we are talking about the birth of Jesus and that whole story on how God sent his son as a baby to really really be to be with us. Okay, so this week we are really excited because we're talking about being joyful. You see, Gabriel appears to Mary in Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 57. It's an incredible story on how God chose a really awesome woman to give birth to his son. And so, kids, I'd love for you to just pay attention to this next video and learn all about how the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary and how Mary said yes to really doing what God is asking her to do, and that is to give birth to Jesus. And so the bottom line today is that you can have joy because God has a plan for you. You see, in this story, we see how God had a plan for Mary. In our monthly verse, I don't know if you are reading the verse or not or memorizing it, but I really want to encourage you kids to memorize this verse. It is, today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. And that is Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Anyway, kids, enjoy this next video, and we'll be right back. And we love y'all, and we miss y'all here at the Downtown Vineyard Church. God bless, kids.
Hey, everybody. It's me, Jacob. Sorry if it seems like I'm in a rush. Gotta make this quick, because it's the holidays. You know what that means? Lots of plans on the old calendar.
I got something happening every single day leading up to the big day.
Christmas! Christmas is celebrating Jesus, God's greatest gift. So, let me see if there's anything new in this big wrapped box. And then I can get busy celebrating. Here we go.
No way.
This is what Christmas is all about, right here. Ginger spiced pecan with a hint of nutmeg, some oregano mixed in just for a little flavor, and sprinkled on top with chocolate sprinkles. And then we mix in some of Aunt Dori's famous protein powder just to build the muscle. Non-dairy, gluten-free, if you can believe it, Dori can make it. And I'm sensing a hint of chocolate now. She's mixing up, she's gone off the grid, she's mixing up the recipe. It smells so good, but the taste, oh! I don't have the words to describe the taste of Aunt Dori's famous pie. I'm gonna need to set this down for a second. My family's been going to Aunt Dori's at Christmas time ever since I was a little kid. That's always been the plan. I get to hang out with my cousins and catch up on old times. We always eat the biggest meal. You never saw so many casseroles. But if your belly's smart, it always saves room for the pie. Sorry. Come on, Jacob, get it together. I'm getting distracted by pie. Sorry. This year, we had to change the plan a little bit. Aunt Dori hasn't been feeling too well, and the family thought it'd be best if we wait until she's feeling better before we get together. It's kind of a bummer when plans don't go the way you'd expect, but we're trying to make the best of things. Find things to be joyful about, you know? Hey, the story today is about changing plans. This girl, Mary, she had to change her plans, not just for the holidays, but for her whole life. And do you think she was able to be joyful? We'll find out in just a minute. I think I'll stick around for the story. And the pie. Maybe just some pie, just a little bit of pie.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 56.
Mary lived in the tiny town of Nazareth, an ordinary village at the edge of Jewish lands.
Nazareth? Can anything good come from there?
Mary herself was an ordinary girl.
Oh, hello.
She grew up learning the Jewish scriptures.
A child will be born to us, a son will be given to us. He will rule over us, and he will be called Wonderful Advisor and Mighty God. When will this happen?
Only God knows. It's been hundreds of years.
Mary went to fetch water from the well and baked loaves of bread and swept out the hard-packed earth floor.
It's important to clean the dirt off the dirt.
She was also engaged to be married to a carpenter named Joseph. Mary must have expected that her life would follow a very ordinary path until one day when everything changed. Greetings, Mary. Suddenly, right there in the dim room, a brilliant being appeared. Mary probably dropped whatever she was holding, a broom, a batch of bread dough, a needle and thread.
Who? Me?
The Lord has blessed you in a special way. He is with you.
Mary blinked, trying to take it all in. The whole room glowed with light.
I don't understand.
Do not be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you.
Mary couldn't find any words. In one heartbeat, her very ordinary day had flipped upside down.
You will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. He will rule forever over his people. That kingdom will never end.
The words of Isaiah may have echoed in Mary's head.
A child will be born to us. A son will be given to us. He will rule over us.
She finally found her voice.
How can this happen? I'm not even married yet.
The light flared even brighter.
The Holy Spirit will make this happen. Your relative Elizabeth will have a child even though she is old. People thought she could not have children, but she has been pregnant for 6 months now. That's because what God says will always come true.
Mary's heart pounded. Her cousin Elizabeth was old enough to be a grandmother, and if she was having a baby, anything could happen.
I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would.
The light faded. The towering angel disappeared. Mary leaned against the wall to collect her thoughts.
Elizabeth, I have to go see her.
The journey to Elizabeth and Zechariah's home in the hill country of Judah would have taken many days of travel along dusty roads. Finally, Mary arrived.
Why, it's Mary.
Elizabeth, I have so much to tell you.
As Mary spoke, Elizabeth could feel the child inside of her leap and kick for joy. God's Holy Spirit spoke to Elizabeth.
God has blessed you more than other women, and blessed is the child you will have. As soon as I heard the sound of your voice, the baby inside of me jumped for joy. You are a woman God has blessed. You have believed that the Lord would keep his promises to you.
Mary laughed and cried at the same time as she hugged her older cousin. God confirmed once again that Mary could find joy in the extraordinary plan God had for her.
Now tell me your story.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for several weeks. She was so filled with joy, she poured out her heart in a song to God.
My soul gives glory to the Lord. My spirit delights in God, my Savior. He has taken note of me, even though I'm not considered important. He shows his mercy to those who have respect for him. He has filled with good things those who are hungry. He has helped the people of Israel who serve him. He has done it just as he had promised to our people of long ago.
At the end of 3 months, Mary returned home to Nazareth, ready to see how God's plan was about to unfold.
I can't believe I just ate that whole pie. Almost the whole pie. That was not part of the plan. But hey, I definitely felt the joy. Maybe you're like me, and your plans had to change for some reason this season. Reason season. I rhymed that on purpose. Nah, I'm just teasing. It is totally okay to feel sad when plans don't go the way you expect. I'm sad I don't get to go to Aunt Dory's. But, like Aunt Dory says, you don't have to dwell on the sadness. You don't have to stay sad forever. There could be a bigger reason why plans change. Think about it. Before God revealed his plan, Mary was just like any one of us. She had her own hopes and dreams for the future, just like we do. But her plans changed because God had a bigger plan for her. It's the same with us. my plans, God's plans. God knows everything that's ever happened, and he knows everything that's going to happen. So, he has a plan for you. It may be different than your plan, but trust me, it's a bigger and better plan. So, if you're sad when plans change, that's okay. Just don't dwell there. You can have joy knowing that your plans are in bigger hands. Plans hands. That sort of rhymes. Here's the one thing to remember today. You can have joy because God has a plan for you. It's cool to think that the creator of the universe has a plan just for me. I don't know about you, but that makes me kind of, also kind of excited. Huh. And kind of hungry. One more slice of pie won't hurt. Ooh, looks like the plans are changing again. Oh boy, the plans are changing fast. I'll catch you next time.
All right, kids, wasn't that such a cool video? I love these videos. I love what it teaches about Jesus. And remember, kids, the basic truth is that we can trust God no matter what. Right? Okay, kids? So let me pray for you. And God bless. Have a great week. Stay safe out there, guys. So, Father, we just come before you. We thank you so much for how you love us. God, we thank you so much for how that no matter what, that we can trust you. And so, Father, I pray that you would just bless our kids, bless our families, Lord. I pray that they would hear from you every day. And Father, we love you. In your name I pray. Amen. Amen. All right. God bless, kids. We'll see you next week.
Manamana. Manamana. Manamana.